Hi my dear friends, welcome to the Analytic Nerd channel. And this channel basically I've created so as to teach all the necessary topics under various subjects related to data science and analytics, which will make you industry ready. Here, after explaining each concept, I have dived into problem solving skills also. Now, here at first I have begun with the SQL series playlist that I've completed. Then I've gone into the Python playlist. These are very handful for your data science and data analytics journey. Now here we have something known as this SQL query editor, and in SQL environment we need to create databases, handle databases, and for that we need to create a database, and under the database we need to create tables, and in tables we can create several records, manage those records, manipulate those records. Now for instance, I have created here a table by the name of emp underscore inc, and if I want to see all the records of this particular table emp underscore inc, then I'll have to write select asterisk from emp underscore inc, that is at the last you'll have to write the name of the table, and before that you'll have to use these keywords select and select, then asterisk, then from, and which table, emp underscore inc. Now hit the execute button. You see all the related fields with respect to this particular table emp underscore inc are shown here, like EID, it stands for employee ID, DEPT, it stands for department, DZ, it stands for designation, salary. Now here I have kept in mind that I have created a hypothetical database regarding employees and their various records. So these are all hypothetical values, but these types of tables and values you'll have to deal with in your original real life scenarios, be it in your business or be it in your job or in a startup, and be it in your college projects also. Okay, so here for instance you can see EID stands for employee ID, and employee ID values are always unique values. Like this particular person doesn't have any, the name value is not included here, but this employee has this employee ID value I1001. Then the next employee has got this EID value I1002. Then the next one has got I1003, and in this way if you scroll down, then you can see here you have the last employee whose employee ID value is I1134. Employee ID values are all unique, never repeated. So here I have the records. How many records here I have got? I have got 79 records. That means records of 79 employees I have got here, and corresponding for them, all the other record values for the fields are also included here. These are again I have included hypothetically just for your understanding, but this is how you are going to basically treat your tables. This is how you are going to get your tables and deal with your tables. Like for example, under department field, the first row contains this operations value. So that means this particular person belongs to the operations department. And under DESI, you have director. So this particular person, I1001, belongs to the operations department and is a director. And what is the salary of this particular person? 48005. Similarly, this particular person whose employee ID value is I1002 belongs to which department? Operations. What is the DESI, that is designation of this person? It is VP, Vice President. What is the salary value of this person? 252005. In this way, for example, if you come to this particular row, row number 4 here, in this particular row, I have created this particular record where the employee ID value of employee is I1004, department is miscellaneous, that is MISC, designation is manager, and salary value is 265577. Hypothetical values all, but this is how in real world scenarios you get your data, and then you have to manage and manipulate your data in your tables under your databases. Now in SQL there is a very important concept known as view. View is a very important concept. What is a view in SQL? It is actually a virtual table which serves as a window to the actual table, and via this view what you can do is you can insert your records that will be reflected in your original table, that is actual table. You can delete records from this view, and then that will be reflected in your actual table also. You can update records via the view, and then that those update values will be also reflected in your original table, that is actual table. So what is the syntax here? You have to use the keywords create, then view, and then give a name to your view, such as in this scenario I have given my underscore view. Then in the next line you have to write this keyword as. Then in the next line select asterisk from emp underscore inc. Like for instance, that is select all the records and all the fields from this particular table emp underscore inc, and in the last line where department is equals to miscellaneous. So just like this, select asterisk from emp underscore inc. Here also I have written select asterisk from emp underscore inc where department is equals to MIS, miscellaneous. So if I select only line 73 to 74, then what will happen? All the fields shall be shown and corresponding records will be shown, but only with respect to MISC, miscellaneous. Okay, so here you see out of 79 rows, here 8 rows are only displayed. Why? Because there are only 8 employees who belong to the department of miscellaneous. You see miscellaneous MISC, MISC, MISC. No other department values included here. So out of all those 79 records, only 8 records have been taken here and displayed out here, because here I am displaying the records with respect to MISC department, miscellaneous department. Okay, so there are 8 employees who belong to the MISC department. Now if I select line 71 to 74 and then hit the execute button, then what will happen? This particular view, that is my underscore view, will be created. And under this view, what will you have? You will have those 8 records under this view. So now if you go to line number 77, just like a table, how you want to access or you want to see the fields and records from a particular table, in similar fashion, you will have to write the same syntax for view also. So select asterisk from, then give the name of the view. And what was the view that I created here? My underscore view. Okay, my underscore view. So if you select line number 77 and hit the execute button, here you see this particular view contains only those 8 rows where the department is miscellaneous. Okay, so that is only miscellaneous department records are stored into this view. Now suppose I want to insert an additional record into the original table, but I do not want to go into the original table. I want to do it via the view. So this concept is very much important in security purposes. Like I want an employee to insert some records into the original table, but I do not want the employee to go and have a look into the original table. In that case, I can use the view concept. So what to do here? Just like how we insert records into a table, in similar way, we have to use the same kind of syntax for view also. Insert into, these two keywords you have to write, then give the view name, that is my underscore view, then give this keyword values. And then inside the brackets, you'll have to give your required values. And these corresponding values shall be inserted under the fields as per as the order. Okay. Like this particular first value, I1136 shall be inserted under the EID column. Then this particular value, MISC, shall be inserted under the department column. Then this particular value, associate, shall be inserted under the DESI column, that is designation column. And this particular salary value, 80,000, shall be inserted under the salary column. So select line 79 to 80 and hit the execute button. And if you again want to see the records of your view, so select asterisk from my underscore view, hit the execute button. You see already there were 8 rows. Now one additional row, that is the 9th row, has been created here thanks to the line codes of 79 to 80 that this additional record got inserted here. Employee ID I1136. So there is a 9th employee also whose record has been inserted, who belongs to the MISC department, that is a miscellaneous department. So I1136 is the employee ID of that particular employee. Department, that particular employee belongs to MISC. What is the DESI, that is designation of that employee? It is associate. What is the salary of that employee? 80,000. Now I want to see that I did this so as to reflect and ensure that this record gets also inserted into the actual table without going into the actual table. So my intention was to insert this record into the original table via the view without going into the original table. And I want this record to be inserted into the actual table. So what can I do here? Now go to your actual table, that is go to line number 69, select asterisk from EMP underscore INC. Initially there we had 79 rows. Now you see, if you follow the cursor and look at this right hand bottom corner, there are now 80 rows. Scroll down and you see initially there were 79 rows. Now we have the 80th number of row where this particular record, entire record of that employee, has been inserted, where EID is I1136, department is miscellaneous, that is MISC, designation is associate, salary is 80,000. Now this view I have created here only with respect to the department value being miscellaneous, MISC. No other department value with respect to any other, that is, if I want to give any other value of department and with respect to that I want to insert a record into the view and into the original table, that won't happen. All these things I have explained in my videos under the SQL playlist. So my request to you is kindly go and have a check on the SQL playlist and go through the SQL videos. go here. Here you can see this is the first class where I have shown how to, you know, download and then give you instructions for installing. And just if I pause this video, then here you can see all the various important related topics related to SQL I have covered up here, like getting started with SQL, then DML, that is data manipulation language, pattern matching with various types of clauses like clause, then order by operator, order by clause, comparison operators, logical operators, convert function, then primary key, unique key, check constraints, foreign key, data query language, okay, then your set operators, indexing in SQL, which is very important, then what are views in SQL, then predefined functions, windows functions, common table expressions, then your string functions in SQL, then date functions, then user defined functions, then triggers in SQL, subqueries in SQL. Subqueries is like a query within a query is a subquery. Then partition by clause in SQL, okay, then procedures, then transactions, then identity property, then sequence in SQL, then case when, all these things, triggers in SQL, all these things I've covered here in this particular playlist, and I've explained the concepts, and I've tried my level best to make these concepts easily understandable to you, and I have given here problems, and also ultimately solve those problems so as to enhance your problem solving skills in data analytics, especially with respect to SQL. And the same thing I have done with Python also. See, so far these Python videos I have created, and shall be bringing out more Python videos. Okay, so if you have liked this, if you have liked this channel, and if you have liked this video, then kindly hit the like, share and subscribe button, and press the bell icon for notifications, and go through the playlists, and you will have a very deeper and solid understanding about data science and analytics, and especially with respect to SQL and Python. So thank you.